one array and we are going to sort that array applying selection sort. Sorting means by default here I am going to sort the array in ascending order. Okay. Now let us take one example. Suppose the array is I am having 6 elements in this array and the name of this array is A. Okay, and the index would be started from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 here. N is equal to 6, 6 elements we have. Okay. Now what is the Fundine selection sort? See, in this case also the array, one array is there, this array would be divided into two subarrays. One is sorted subarray and another is unsorted subarray. Fine. Same in insertion sort, but see here the funda is different from the insertion sort. Initially we consider that the sorted sublist or subarray is empty, no element is there. Okay, here like this, this side we have sorted subarray and this complete is unsorted subarray. Now what is the next step? From this unsorted sublist we will find out the minimum element. Okay, we will find out the minimum element and that element, that minimum element would be swapped with the element which is at the starting position in this unsorted subarray. See, like here the minimum element is 1, so this element would be swapped with this element at the starting of this, unsorted subarray element is 7, so this 1 would be swapped with this 7, 1 would go here and 7 would go here. Fine. So simple funda is from the unsorted subarray find out the minimum element and then swap with that minimum element with the element which is placed at the beginning, at the beginning of the unsorted subarray. See, now let us take this example. This is our array. Now its starting sorted subarray is empty, no element is there, and this is unsorted subarray. This complete is unsorted subarray. Now from this subarray find out the minimum element. You apply the linear search. I hope you know the concept how to find out the minimum element. Maybe the element which is at the starting, consider it as a minimum element and compare this element with all the elements. And if you find the element, one element which is less than this element, then you can consider that as minimum element. I'll discuss that thing in code, in coding also. So anyhow, by some method we have found out that from this element this A1 is minimum element. Now next step is this one would be replaced, this one would be swapped with the element which is at the starting of this unsorted subarray. At starting we have element 7. So here we write what? 1, and here we write what? 7, and all the elements would be same, 4, 10, 8 and 3. Now this is our array. So this is, you can consider pass 1. Now see, this is, now in our sorted subarray we have one element, that is 1. Now this is sorted subarray and this complete is unsorted subarray. Now we are going to put as it is this sorted subarray and we are going to deal with this unsorted subarray. Now unsorted subarray is from 1 to 5. At starting it was from 0 to 5. Now it is unsorted subarray. Now the next step is what? In pass 2, what you will do? Same step, from the unsorted subarray find out the minimum element. Minimum element is what? This 3, and swap this 3 with the element which is at the starting, but which is at the beginning of this unsorted subarray. At the beginning of this unsorted subarray the element is 4. So what you will do, 3 would be at the place of 4 and 4 would go at the place of 3, and the remaining elements are as it is, 7, 8, here we have 10, here we have 1. Now this is the array in pass 2. So now this is now sorted subarray and this is now unsorted subarray. Fine. Now you keep it sorted subarray as it is and you deal with this unsorted subarray. Fine. In pass 3, what you will do, from this unsorted subarray find out the minimum element. Minimum element is what? This 4, and place this minimum element or swap this minimum element with this 10, because at beginning of this unsorted subarray the element is 10. So what you will do, 4 will go here and 10 will go at the place of 4. All the elements would be as it is, 1 and 3. Now this is the array. Now this is sorted subarray. Now this is sorted subarray and this remaining is unsorted subarray. Fine. Now from the unsorted subarray find out the minimum element. Minimum element is 7 and we are going to place, we are going to swap this minimum element with this 8, because at the beginning, at the starting of this unsorted subarray the element is 8. So we will write down 7 here, 8 here, and remaining element would be as it is 1, 3 and 4. Now our sorted subarray is this much and this remaining two elements are in unsorted subarray, and this is pass 4. And in pass 5, what you will do, from the unsorted subarray find out the minimum element. Minimum element is 8 and swap this minimum element with the element which is in the starting of this unsorted subarray. At starting of this unsorted subarray we have 10. So we'll swap out this one. 8 would go here and 10 would go at the place of 8. Remaining element would be 7, 4, 3 and 1. Now see this. This much is sorted subarray. And in unsorted subarray we have only one element. Fine. So no need to sort this one, because if one element is there then obviously that is always sorted. So you can say that if 6 elements are there, now we have sorted 5 elements, so automatically 6th element would be at its appropriate place. So no need to do another operation. So here 6 elements are there, number of passes required are 5, means n minus 1 passes, same as in bubble sort. Fine. Because 6 elements are there, you have already sorted 5 elements, then the last element, the remaining one element will always fall at its appropriate place. No need to sort that element. So this is the funda of selection sort. Okay. Now how to write down this into code? Here two loops would be there. One is for this passes, 5 passes are there, means n minus 1. So outer loop would be for these passes. And second element is, second loop is for what? To find out the minimum element from the unsorted array and for the swapping, or you can say to find out the minimum element from that array. Okay, see, now outer loop would be from I is equal to 0 to be less than n minus 1 and I plus plus. So this loop is for this passes is 5, so we will start from 0 to less than n minus 1. N is 6, 6 minus 1 is 5. Okay, so I value would be from, see, in pass 1 I value is 0, here I value is 1, here I value is 2, here I value is 3 and I value is 4. So 5 passes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is why I have written less than n minus 1. Fine. Now see, next what you will do, how to find out a minimum element? First thing is, just consider the first element is the minimum element. Okay, now see what. We will take another variable min. We will initialize this min with the value that is I value. Okay. So now see, at starting when I value is 0, I is here and min is a variable, and min is, the value of min is also 0, because I is 0, na? So here we have 0. Now what you will do, now you will compare this element with these elements to find out the minimum element. I hope you know the concept how to find out a minimum element, how to search, how to do linear search. See, now for, we are going to start another loop and we are going to compare this element with this one. So we are going to start from here. So j would be I plus 1. We are going to compare this element with this element. So this element is at index I. So we are going to start from here. So j is starting from here only. J is equal to I plus 1. And j would go till what? Less than n. J would go what? Less than n, that is till 5. We are going to compare this 7 with all the elements. So till n and j plus plus. Now what to do? Now compare. If this element A of J is less than this element, so now compare if this A of J element is less than A of min. See, min is what? That value is I. So min is what? Here only. Now min is at this place only, here only. Okay, if this condition is true, if this element is less than this element, then obviously minimum element would be this one, right? At starting we have considered this and this as minimum element. But if this element you find is less than this element that we have considered as in starting as minimum element, so minimum element would be updated, na? So this is now the minimum element. So what you will do? You will do what? You will update this min variable and min is equal to J now. In if you have, we have only one statement. Okay. Now see. Now I will close this for loop. And after this for loop, you will check if min is not equal to I, then what you will do? Swap A of I and A of min. See, why you are checking this condition? In starting we have considered this value of this main variable is same as I, but when you are comparing this element with another elements, then you find out that some another element is minimum element, some another element is minimum than this element that we have considered minimum in starting. Okay, so that is why we have updated this min value. So min value and I value is not same now. If min value and I value is not same, then you have to do swapping. In this case we have done one swapping of 1 and 7. So see, let us trace out this code. At starting I value is 0, fine. I is less than equal to n minus 1. Yes, this condition is true. N minus 1 is 5, 0 is less than 5. Then we will go to this case, into this for loop. So now see, min is a variable, min, and the value of this min is same as I is equal to 0. See, min is 0. Now J is equal to I plus 1. Now J would be 0 plus 1, that is 1, and 1 is less than n, 1 is less than 6, that this condition is true. We'll go into this loop. Now check if A of J, it means we are going to check A of 1 less than A of min value is 0, A of 0. Now check, A of 1 is this one, this is less than this. Yes, this condition is true. That is why we are updating this value of min. Now min value of this min variable is J. Now J value is 1, so this would be updated to 1. Now min value is 1. Okay, now see, after this one again J plus plus would be there. Now J value is 2. 2 is less than 6. Yes, this condition is true. We will go to this loop. Now check A of 2, A of J less than A of min. Now min value is 1 now. A of 1. See, now A of 2 is A of 2 less than A of 1. A of 1 is 4. Is this 10 less than 4? No, this condition is not true. So now min is not updated, because if this condition is not true, the control will not go within these statements. Now again J plus plus. J is now 3. Now check A of 3 less than A of min. Min value is still 1. Now check A of 3 value is 8. A of 1 is 4. Is this 8 less than 4? No. So we'll not enter into this loop. Now min will not be updated. Now J plus plus. J is now 4. Okay, now check A of 4 less than A of min value is still 1. A of 4 is 3 and A of 1 is 4. 3 less than 4, yes, this condition is true. Now minimum value would be, now we will enter into this loop, and now min is equal to J. Now min value would be updated and J value is what? 4. Now min value is 4. Okay, now here we have that pointer, min pointer. Okay, now see, Again, J plus plus, J is equal to 5. 5 is less than 6. Yes, condition is true. A control will go to this loop. Now check A of J. J is 5. A of 5 less than A of min. Now min value is 4. A of 4. A of 5 is 1. A of 4 is 3. Is 1 less than 3? Yes, this condition is true. Now control will go to this loop. So obviously minimum element is this one. So minimum, the value of this minimum variable would be updated. And min is equal to j. Now j value is 5. So minimum is equal to now 5. Now again j plus plus. J is equal to 6. 6 is less than 6. No, this condition is not true. The control will not go within this loop. Control will go out from this loop. And from out from this loop, the control will go here only. This is the statement. Okay. Now check. If min not equal to I. Now min value is 5. And I value is. See, I value is 0 still. Okay, we have started from 0 only. I value is 0. So 5 is not equal to 0. Yes, this condition is true. Fine. Now we will enter into this loop and what will happen? Swapping of A of I. A of I. I means 0. Means A of 0 and A of min is what? 5. Value of min is 5. So now A of 0 and A of 5. Swapping of this one. 1 would go here, 7 would go here. And that's what we have done. Okay, so this is the code for this selection sort. So you just take out another case also. I value you can take 1 or 2 and you just trace out this code and you find out that this code is absolutely right. I have just taken one case and I trace out this code with that case and we have find out that we have after this, after executing of this code, 1 would be swapped, 1 would be swapped with 7, and that's what we have done when we are discussing this numerical without this code. So what about the time complexity? So the time complexity of selection sort is order of n square, both in worst case and best case. Because see, how many times this inner loop would be computed? Obviously n square time, fine. Because this would go from 0 to n minus 1. If I value is 0, then also it would go from 1 to n. When I value is 1, then also this would go from 2 to n. If I value is 3, I value is 2 suppose, then this also goes from 3 to n. Every time it is going approximately n times. So that is why we are going to write it n square times. So this is all about selection sort, and in next video I am going to discuss with you quick sort. So I will see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye, take care.